Ying. Okay, may I use you to take your seat, please? Okay. Good afternoon. I hope you had a very nice lunch and you are ready for the draw. The draw of the 30th Summer Universiade in Naples, and I hope that at the same time, during the couple of days before the draw, you had the time to appreciate and to visit the venues where we will have the games in 3 months. And I would like to thank, of course, the organizing committee and all the team that have been with you during those 3 days. And I'm sure that we will have here in Naples great edition of the Summer Universiade. Don't forget that we celebrate as well the 60th anniversary of the Universiade. The first one was as well in Italy, in Torino, in 1959. Great success for the tournament. We have 10 tournaments during these games in Naples, and we'll have already 128 teams registered, which is a great success. Then thanks to all of you. Really, you did a great job to bring all those teams to Naples. For your information, the draw will be as well live on the FISU Facebook page. And if you want to communicate with your country, you can tell them that they can watch the draw live on the FISU Facebook page. As you know, because we talked about this many times today, we had to reduce the number of participants, and I would like to thank all of you for your contribution to help us to reduce the number, and of course our technical people that help us to reduce the quota of participants. We moved from 11 to a bit more than 8,000 people. And of course, for that, we had to reduce the number of teams that we had in the tournaments. Of course, it was a big choice and difficult choice for FISU to reduce the sport or to reduce the participants and the teams. We decided not to touch to the original program, which was 18 sports, and to try to find a way to reduce the number of people. That will allow us to keep the original program, and I would like to thank the organizing committee for having supported us in this difficult decision. Now, 18 sports will be in Naples. For the one that were in 1989 in Duisburg, remember we had also some problems, and then we went to 4 sports. We had the games with 4 sports. Here, thanks to Italian friends, we will have the 18 sports. Thank you so much. A very special thanks to our technical people. We have here with us a couple of them, not all of them are here. First of all, the chair of the technical committee, Jean-Paul Clemenceau. For the basketball, Ulf Ormans and Kosta Iliev. For the football, Andrei Vlasov. For the volleyball, Melanie Sanford and Khosrov Ibrahim. And for water polo, Nikolaos Vasiliou. But of course, we had other technicians in other sports, individual sports, that have been very, very helpful and active to prepare these games in Naples. Coming back to the draw, you have all of you have paid 5,000 euro for the registration of each and every team. That money will be transferred to the OC in order to cover part of your stay in the athletes' village. Please make sure that your head of delegation will bring the original receipt sent by FISU and that you will present this receipt to the OC department at the time of the payment of the stay. Before starting the draw, I would like to remind you that as all of you have confirmed their participation in the team sports, any further withdrawal after the draw will be fined by a 5,000 euro penalty. Then you will lose the guarantee. Good. Now I would like to inform you about the general principle of the draw. We talk about the number of pools, number of teams, ranking, draw, and the way we will organize the draw. The teams are divided into four pools. Next slide. When we have 12 teams or more, means 12 teams or 16 teams, we will have four pools of four. For example, basketball, men and women, football, men and women, and volleyball, men and women. With some competition and tournament with two pools, we'll have rugby seven, men and women, and water polo, men and women. Then, talking about the ranking. Teams have been divided into tiers following the previous Universiade result, then the FISU ranking, and if there is no FISU ranking, the International Sports Federation ranking. Regarding the draw, first, we will draw the pool, and of course by tiers, from A to D or A to B. Then we will pay special attention to the continental distribution, and we will try to have no more than two countries from the same continent in the same pool. I believe it's more fair to have exchange of games between different continents than to have the same continents represented in one pool. Exception of basketball men, water polo men and women, where we will have some pools with three countries from the same continent, because sometimes we have many countries from Europe and Asia and or Americas and not from different continents. We will try as well to, as much as we can, to have the distribution of the teams following the continents as well, means that in each pool we will try to have one continent represented. That's why sometimes we will have to place some team. Don't be afraid. We want to apply this for the whole tournament. And something that we have already applied for many years in volleyball, but we will now allocate a number for the preliminary round, means that we will avoid that we will have a very strong team playing a very weak team or weakest team at the beginning of the tournament. Then, after the draw, we will assign a random number to place the people, the teams in the pool. For example, if you are country X, you can be in tier 1, but place in position 3, means that you will play in A3. Clear? Now let's start the draw, and I will give the floor to our director of Summer Games, Mark Van den Plas.
Okay, to help us for the draw, we have the organizing committee and FISU have decided to have some great sports ambassadors, Italian sports ambassador, to help us to do the draw. And for the women basketball that will start the draw, we have Liliana Mabel Bocchi. So Liliana is a former Italian basketball player. She's used to play as a center, and she started her sports career playing for the Partenio Avellino, which Mabel contributed to reach the Serie A for the first time in the whole history of the team. She won 8 Italian championships and 1 Champions Cup. During the 1975 World Tournament, she was awarded with the Best Player Prize, and she also scored more than any other. She has 121 appearances for the national team, and she's a member of the FIBA Basketball Hall of Fame. So during Taipei Summer Universiade in 2017, something very unusual has happened. The USA women's team has been eliminated in the quarterfinal of the tournament. The name of the big favorite killer, Australia, that managed later to the conquest of gold by winning its semifinal against Chinese Taipei before beating Japan in final by 85-79. So Australia won the gold, Japan the silver, and Chinese Taipei won the bronze medal against Russia. And we are sure that Napoli will be the host of very open and high level competition.
And now let's start the draw for basketball women. We will start with Australia, Japan, Chinese Taipei, and Russia. We first draw the pool. In the pool C, we'll play their special ball, very difficult to open. Chinese Taipei. In the pool D, we'll play Australia. Next pool. Pool A. Japan. And of course, in the pool B, we will have Russia. Okay, now we go to the next line with USA, Canada, Czech Republic, and Portugal. We have now no problem with the continental representation. We can draw freely USA, Canada, Czech, and Portugal. In the pool A, we'll play Czech Republic. In the pool C, USA. In the pool B, we'll play Portugal. And the last one in the pool D, the last team, which is Canada. we can have maximum two European countries from Europe. Therefore, we will not be able afterwards to throw European countries in the pool B. Then you have to know it from the beginning. Because in the next draw, we have Hungary, Argentina, China and Mexico, and we will draw Hungary in the pool A, C and D. A, C and D for Hungary. Hungary will play in the pool A. Then we have only four countries from Americas, and we don't want to have two countries from Americas in the same pool. Therefore, we have to place Argentina in the pool B. And now we will draw China and Mexico, because unfortunately we have the pool A should have been as well with two American teams. Then we put China in pool D. And Argentina in pool C. Mexico in pool C. Some remarks from the president? Okay. Now we will draw Romania, Slovakia, Ukraine and Finland. In pool C we'll play Slovakia, in pool D we'll play Finland. In pool A we'll play Ukraine. And the last pool in pool B. Romania. Okay, now we will give a number for each and every team per pool. We will start with pool A. Japan, Czech Republic, Hungary and Ukraine. Japan will play in pool A4. Czech Republic in A2. Hungary will play in A3. And the last from the pool A, Ukraine will play in pool A1. Then we go to the pool B. Russia, Portugal, Argentina, Romania. Russia will play in pool 3, B3. Portugal will play in B1. Argentina will play in pool B4. And Romania, of course, in pool B2. Now we go to the next pool, Taipei, USA, Mexico, and Slovakia. Taipei will play in C2. USA in C1. Mexico C4. And Slovakia in C3. Last pool, pool D, Australia, Canada, China, Finland. Australia will play in pool D3. Canada will play in pool D4. China in pool D1, and the last team, of course, Finland, will play in pool D2. That concludes the draw for the basketball women.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Madal. And now we have, after Madal Boki, we have another very, very famous player, basketball player. And his name is Manfredo Fucile. And Manfredo is going to help us also for the draw. He's a former very, very known Italian basketball player. Among his major victories, he's worth considering the Coppa del Coppa, the European Cup in 1969-1970, and he won it with Fides Partenope. He is the president of the Italian Basketball Federation, and he really represents the whole Campania basketball movement. Now, if we tell you that Taipei was not a so good sporting memory for the U.S. basketball, we think that we are not too far from the reality, because the U.S. guys, like their countrywoman, has also lost their title. But at least they could grab the silver medal, losing in final only by 11 points against a very spectacular team of Lithuania who has conquered an enthusiastic Taiwanese crowd. It looks like the Taiwanese air has doped the Baltic countries as Latvia crushed Serbia for the bronze medal. No doubt that USA will come in Napoli with a will of revenge, but the competitors are also from very high level.
Okay, then we start with the first tier with USA, Latvia, Germany and Israel. In pool B will play Latvia, in pool C will play USA. Next pool, pool D. Germany. And the last team, it's Israel, will play, of course, the last pool, pool A. For the next line, we have two countries from Americas. Therefore, we will draw the countries from Americas in the three pools where we have no American teams. And we will draw Argentina and Canada in the pool A, B, and D. Let's go. A, B, and D. In the pool D, we'll play Canada, and in the pool B, we'll play Argentina. And now we'll draw Finland and Australia in the pool A and C. In the pool A, we'll play Australia. And of course, in the last pool, pool C, we'll play Finland. As we have 10 European teams, we have no problem with the continental representation. Therefore, we will draw the next line, Russia, Czech Republic, Norway, and Ukraine, in the four pools, A to D. We draw the pool. In the pool D, Norway. Next pool. In the pool C, Ukraine. Next pool, in the pool B, Russia. And the last team, Czech Republic, will play in the pool A. As we have the possibility to have a good distribution of the continental distribution, we will place now the next country from Americas, Mexico, in the pool A, and we will draw freely China, Croatia, and Italy in B, C, and D. Okay, we draw the pool, B, C, and D. Pool D, Italy. Next pool, pool B. Croatia. And China will play, obviously, in the pool C, which is the last pool of the draw in pool C. And now we are going to give a number for each and every team in the pools. We start with Israel, Australia, Czech Republic, and Mexico. Israel will play in A2. Australia will play in A3. Czech Republic will play in A1. And in A4, we will have Mexico. Now for the pool B, we take Latvia, Argentina, Russia, and Croatia. Latvia will play in B1. Argentina will play in B4. Russia will play in B3. And Croatia in the last box empty, B2. Now with pool C, USA, Finland, Ukraine, and China. USA will play in C3. Finland will play in C2. Ukraine will play in C4. And China in C1. Now we go to the last pool. Germany, Canada, Norway, and Italy. Germany will play in D1. Canada will play in D2. Norway in D4, and Italy in D3. And that concludes the draw for the basketball men.
Okay, thank you, Manfredo. And now we are going to the women's football draw. And we have, as an ambassador, Miss Valeria Pironi. Valeria, if you can move, please. Thank you. Yes. Okay, Valeria is a very famous Italian football player, and she played with the national Italian team until 2011. She's presently the forward of Chievo Verona Valpo. She has played for Napoli, where she played 200 times for Napoli. She played for Roma, Verona, Mozzanica, and now for Chievo Verona. welcome Valeria, and just to tell you about what has happened in Taipei, you have first to know that it's the last time that football will be in the program of the Universiade. You have indeed to know that football will be part now from our league program. So we suppose that the team, all the teams will fight to be the last one to figure at the head of the official result of the Summer Universiade. So we will see who will succeed to the Brazilian girls, who won the Taipei gold against Japan. Russia won the bronze, and South Africa was also semi-finalist. So no one knows who will be the next winner, but one thing is sure, the women's competition will be, as always, from very high level. Eric, we can start.
We can start, fantastic. Let's go for the first line with Brazil, Japan, Russia and South Africa. In Pool C, Brazil. Next pool. In Pool A, South Africa. Next pool. In Pool B, Russia. And in the Pool D will be the last team of the line, which is Japan. Okay, as you can see, we have already one American team in Pool C. And in the next draw, we have two other American teams. Then to guarantee a good distribution, as we can do it now, we'll draw USA and Canada in the pool A, B, and D. Pool D, USA. Next pool. Pool A. Of course, Canada. And now we will draw the two Asian teams, Korea and China, in the pool B and C. Pool. In the pool B we'll play China. And in the pool C, of course, Korea. As you can see, we have actually four Asian teams in the tournament. Therefore, we will not draw, but we will place the next Asian teams in the third line, and it is People's Republic of Korea that will play in the pool A. Then we have as well four American teams. And as you can see, we have already in pool C and in pool D, as well in pool A, one American team, but not in the pool B. Therefore, we will place Mexico in the pool B. And then we will draw the two last teams, which are European teams, Ireland and Italy, in the pool C and D. In the Pool D will play Italy. And Ireland will play in the Pool C. Ireland Pool C, and now we'll give a number to all those teams per pool. We will start with South Africa, Canada, and People's Republic of Korea. South Africa will play in A3. Canada will play in A2. And People's Republic of Korea will play in A1. Now we go to the B pool with Russia, China, and Mexico. Russia will play in pool B2. China will play in B3. And Mexico, of course, will play in the last box in B1. Let's go to the Pool C with Brazil, Korea, and Ireland. Brazil will play in C2. Korea in C3, and Ireland in C1. And that concludes the draw for the women's football. Oh, sorry, I forgot about the Pool D. You see, Japan, USA, Italy. Japan will play D2. USA D3. And Italy in D1. And now that concludes the draw for the women's football.
Thanks a lot, Valeria. And now we are going to meet our next ambassador. I think that he is very known here. He's called Alex Mere. He's there. Yes? Okay. Alex Mere is very known because I know that he's playing here for the Napoli first team, and he was on the 21 Italian goalkeeper. He's already played for the first team of Italy against Albania and for friendly games against Holland. He has played for Udinese, he played for Spal, and then afterwards he has been playing for Napoli, and he's been with the first team since 2018. Welcome to you, Alex. So now, if France won the last World Cup in Russia, in Taipei they couldn't clinch the gold. Of course, because they were beaten by a very surprising Japanese team who won 1-0 in a very thrilling final. Mexico won the bronze against Uruguay. There were no goals for this game, but the bronze was awarded after a breath-breaking shootout session. We perfectly know that Italy will be one of the favorites in Napoli, but I can tell you that the local team will really have to fight for the gold. So let's move to the draw. Eric?
Thank you. Pool. First line, now we go for the pool. Pool C will play France. Next pool. Pool A will play Uruguay. Next pool. Pool B will play Mexico. And last pool, the pool D, will play Japan. Now for the continental distribution, we will first draw Brazil, next American team in the next line, in the pool where we have no American teams, mean C and D. Then in C and D, we draw Brazil. C and D. You don't have the C? Okay. C, Brazil in C, together with France. And as we have only two Asian countries, we will draw Korea, not in the pool D, but in the pool A and B. Then we take Korea and we draw Korea in pool A and B. Korea will play in pool A. And now we will draw in pool B and D, Italy and Russia. In pool B, Italy. And of course, in pool D, Russia. Russia in pool D. Good. We have one American team in Mexico in pool B, Brazil in pool C, and we have Uruguay in pool A. Then now we will place Argentina in the pool D, where we have no American team. And then we will then freely draw Ireland, South Africa, and Ukraine in A, B, and C. In pool B, we'll play Ukraine. In pool A, Ireland. And the last one, South Africa will play in pool C. And now we will give a number to each and every team, starting with the pool A. Uruguay, Korea, and Ireland. Uruguay will play in A2. Korea in A1. And of course, Ireland will play in A3. Pool B, Mexico, Italy, Ukraine. Mexico will play in B2. Italy will play in B1. and Ukraine will play in the last line, B3. Now we go to the Pool C with France, Brazil and South Africa. France will play in C1. Brazil will play in C3. And South Africa in C2. Last pool, Pool D. Japan, Russia, Argentina. Japan will play in D3. Russia in D2. And Argentina in D1. And that concludes the football men tournament draw.
Okay, thank you a lot, Alex. And now we are going with the volleyball women draw, and we want to welcome Martina Ferrara. Martina. So Martina is an Italian volleyball player and she plays as a libero. She was born in Avellino. She's student of physical education and sports science at the University of Salerno. She's the most awarded and youngest athlete in Campania in the last 40 years. Indeed, she won the Italian championship under 18, under 16, again under 18 in 2016 and 2017. Welcome, Martina. So, when you talk about international women volleyball, the names of some countries are coming always in your mind. And the one of Russia is one of them. Therefore, when one discovers that Russia was at the top of the podium in Taipei, no one could be surprised. Japan made a formidable tournament and finished second, while Ukraine clinched the bronze medal. All those teams will be present in Napoli, and they will be also among all the favorites. So we can go with the draw now.
And we will draw for the first line Russia, Japan, Ukraine, and Chinese Taipei. In Pool A, we'll play Russia. In Pool C, Chinese Taipei. In Pool D, Japan. In Pool B, Ukraine. Okay, good. As we have already two countries from Asia in the Pool C and D, and we have only four Asian countries in the tournament, we will draw the next Asian country from the second line, means Thailand, in the Pool A and B. Then Pool A and B, Thailand in Pool A. And then we have three countries from America, Argentina, Brazil, USA, that we will draw freely in Pool B, C and D. the pool first. In pool D. USA. In pool B. Brazil. Yes, next. In pool C. Argentina. Great. Now we're going to the third line. As you can see, we have in pool D, C, and A already one Asian team, but no in pool B. Therefore, we will place the last Asian team, China, in pool B. We have five American teams, means that we could have two American teams in the same pool. Therefore, we will draw now Canada, Switzerland, and Czech Republic in the three last pool. In the pool, D, Switzerland. In the pool A, Canada. And in the pool C, Czech Republic. We do not have any problem with the continental representation because we can have two teams from Americas in the same pool. As I explained, we have five teams from Americas. Therefore, we will draw freely Mexico, Italy, Germany, and Hungary. We draw A, B, C, D. Pool C. Hungary. Pool D. Italy. In the pool A, Mexico, and the pool B, Germany. And now let's give a number to each and every team. We start with the pool A, Russia, Thailand, Canada, and Mexico. Russia will play in A3. Thailand will play in A2. C- Canada will play in A1 and Mexico, of course, in A4. Second pool will be Ukraine, Brazil, China and Germany. Ukraine will play in pool B3. Brazil in B1. China B4, and the last team, Germany, of course, in the last box, B2. Now we go with Taipei, Argentina, Czech Republic and Hungary from the Pool C. Chinese Taipei will play in C1. Argentina in C4. Czech Republic will play in C2. And Hungary in C3. Good, now we'll go to the last pool, Pool D, Japan, USA, Switzerland and Italy. Japan will play D3. USA D1. Switzerland D2. And Italy will be, of course, in D4. And that concludes the draw for the volleyball women tournament.
Okay, thanks a lot. Thank you. And now I will ask a very famous Italian player, volleyball player Giacomo Diretto, to come. I hope that I will be able to finish his CV, to tell you his CV before the end of the day, because he has a tremendous record. With Parma, he won 2 Italian championships, 1 Italy Cup, 1 CV, 1 European Cup and 1 European Super Cup. He went to Cuneo, he won 1 Italy Super Cup, 2 European Cup and 2 European Super Cup. Then he went to Treviso, he won 1 Italian title, 1 Italian Super Cup, the Champions Cup and the European Super Cup. Then he went to France, he won the French League, to Roma, another European Cup, and then as a summary, he won World Cup for Italy and 2 consecutive World League, 94 and 95. Please welcome Giacomo Diretto. So when FISU members and sports lovers are talking about the best sports moments in Taipei, they always refer to the wonderful volleyball final between Iran and Russia. After 2 hours and 12 minutes of an incredible high-level game, Iran has realized a very big upset, winning the gold at the end of a thrilling tiebreak, 15-30. Japan won the bronze, while Ukraine finished fourth. We have no doubt that on its own ground, Italy will be one of the biggest favorites for gold. Please, we can move to the draw.
Okay, and we start with some explanation that for this tournament we have a special request that have been given by the organizing committee to go to 20 teams, and of course with all the force the organizing committee and Italy has done for this to organize these games in 2.5 years. We have accepted the proposal, and then we will draw now 20 teams for this tournament. And we will start in Iran, Russia, Japan and Ukraine for the first line. In Pool C, Iran, in Pool A, Ukraine. In Pool D, Japan. And in Pool B, Russia. Great, now we go to the second line and we draw Brazil, Argentina, Czech Republic and Portugal. Yes, the pool, please. In Pool A, Czech Republic. Next pool. In Pool C, Brazil. Next pool, in Pool D, Argentina. And last pool in Pool B, of course, Portugal. Great. As we have 8 European teams, we will try to have no more than 2 European teams in each and every pool. Therefore, we will draw the 2 next European teams, France and Switzerland, in the pool C and D. In Pool D, we'll play Switzerland. And in Pool C, France. And now we'll draw the 2 Asian teams of the line, which are Taipei, Chinese Taipei and Korea in Pool A and B. In Pool B we'll play Korea. And in Pool A, Chinese Taipei. Great. Now, if you look at the continental distribution, we have to draw now three American teams and one Asian team. Then there is no problem for the American teams because we can have two teams from Americas in one pool, as we have six American teams. And we can have as well two teams from Asia in one pool because we have as well six teams from Asia. Therefore, we will draw freely now in pool A, B, C, D, Mexico, Canada, USA, and Hong Kong. In pool C, Canada. In pool D, Mexico. In pool B, USA. And in pool A, Hong Kong. Great. Pool A, we have two European teams, two Asian teams. Pool B, we have two European teams, one American team, one Asian team. Pool C, we have two American teams, one European team, one Asian team. And we have two American teams in the Pool D, one American team, one Asian team, and one European team. And we remain Chile, China, Poland, and Italy. We don't want to have more than two countries from Europe in the pools, therefore we will draw Poland and Italy in the pool C and in the pool D. In the pool D we'll play Italy. And in the pool C, Poland. Good. Now we have to play the team because, as I mentioned before, we can have more than two teams from Asia in the same pool, then we will place China in the pool B together with Korea. And Chile will go to the pool where we have no American team at all in the pool A. And now we go to the numbers. Ukraine, Czech, Taipei, Hong Kong, Chile. Ukraine will play in A4. Czech Republic will play in A5. Chinese Taipei in A3. Hong Kong, China will play in A1 and Chile will play in A2. Now we go to the pool B. And we have Russia, Portugal, Korea, USA, and China. Russia will play in B3. Portugal in B4, Korea in B5, USA in B2, and China will play in B1. Good, now we go to the pool C with Iran, Brazil, France, Canada, and Poland. Iran will play in C4. Brazil, C2. France, C3. Canada, C1, and Poland in C5. Good, now we go to the pool D. And we go to the pool D with Japan, Argentina, Switzerland, Mexico, and Italy. Japan will play in D1. Argentina D5. Switzerland D3. Mexico D2. And Italy in D4. And that concludes the volleyball men tournament. Coffee break? There is a request for a coffee break. If you But I believe that all of you would like to go forward with the draw. Then no coffee break, as our delegates would like to finish with the draw. Thank you. They don't want. Well, it seems that some people need not a coffee break, but just a short break. Then please, if you have some special need, we have 10 minutes break.
Thank you.
Non, je ris.
Gracias. Thank you.
Merci mon ami.
Chaga.
Thank you.
Okay, I believe the break was enough for everyone. Then if we can call the people. Welcome. Okay. Then we will start with a famous Italian sport, water polo.
Okay, we are going to start with the water polo women draw. And for this water polo women draw, we are waiting for the ambassador of with the name of Alessia Morvillo. Oh, sorry, I didn't see you. Welcome, Alessia. Alessia so is an Italian water polo player. She has also a degree in business administration. She plays for Messina on loan from Flegreo, the team where she started to play water polo. She really contributed to the victories of her team in Campania and led to the playoff of Serie A2 in a few years from Serie C. During the last season, she scored 39 times. She's improving enormously, and she's considered as one of the most talented players of the Italian female water polo panorama.
Bravo.
So, when one remembers the women tournament in Taipei, the performance of the US team was really astonishing. They have combined the results and the show. Beaten for the gold is in one sense final. Hungary can testify about the quality of the US girls. Japan bronze medal has shown that the preparation for the 2020 Olympic Games was quite successful. The tournament in Napoli will be really an open one. And we can go with this draw.
Great. We have in the draw 10 teams that will be drawn. And we will start with, in two pools, USA and Hungary. In pool A we'll play Hungary. And in pool B, of course, the second country, USA. Second line, we will draw Japan and Russia. In pool A, we'll play Japan. And of course, Russia will play in the pool B. Okay, we do have only two American teams in the tournament and two Asian teams. Means that for the next line, we will place Canada in the pool where we have no American teams, which is USA. Then in Pool A, Canada will play in Pool A. And Australia will play in the Pool B. As we have five European teams, there is no problem to draw the next one, which is Italy and France. In Pool B, Italy. And in Pool A, France. We have only two countries from Asia, Japan and China. Therefore, we will place China in the pool where we have no Asian teams, which means the Pool B. And the last European teams will play in the Pool A, which is Czech Republic. And now we will give a number to each and every teams. We start with the Pool A with Hungary, Japan, Canada, France and Czech Republic. Hungary will play in pool in line in pool A1. Japan will play in A4. Canada will play in A2. France in A5. And Czech Republic in the last box available in A3. Now we go to the Pool B with USA, Russia, Australia, Italy, and China. USA will play in B1. Russia in B5. Australia in B2. Italy in B3, and China in B4. And that concludes the draw for the Water Polo Women Tournament.
Thanks a lot, Alessia. And now we are going to invite Massimo Di Martire for the men's draw. So Di Martire is a very known name for Posillipo Napoli because the father won six championships, one Champions League and two Coppa de Coppa with Posillipo, and the son is following the same path. He was already two times with the university team in Guangzhou, and he was also in Taipei. He's under 20 years old national team. And he will be, I'm sure, there for Italy during our games. So now, water polo, the water polo tournament in Taipei, well, you know, Serbian men have developed a real love story with the water polo tournament. In Taipei, Serbia was really on another planet. The score 15-4 for its final against Russia proves it without any doubt. Italy won the bronze against France, but in Napoli, the situation will be very different. First of all, because Serbia will not take part of the competition. It's a bad news for us, but not for everyone. In a region that has generated numerous water polo top stars, Italy appears to be the candidate number one for the gold. But Croatia, Russia, and Hungary, just to mention those, are going to be among the biggest contenders. Now we can go to the draw.
Good. We start with the first line with Russia and Italy. In Pool B will play Italy. Italy. And the second team, Russia, will play, of course. In the Pool A, Russia in Pool A. Good. The two next team will be France and Hungary. We draw the pool first. In Pool A will play France. And of course in Pool B, Hungary. Let's go to the next line with Japan and USA. We draw the pool. In Pool B, Japan. And in Pool A, USA. Next line, we will have Great Britain and Australia. There is no problem with the continental distribution, as we have already six teams in the tournament from Europe. Then we can have three from the same continent from Europe. Then we draw freely Great Britain and Australia. In Pool B, we'll play Australia. And Great Britain will play in Pool A. Good. We have only two teams from Asia. Therefore, it is fair to split the two teams from Asia to different pools. Therefore, we will place Korea in the pool where we have no Asian teams, means Pool A. And we will have Croatia placed in the second pool, in the Pool B. Great, now we can start to give them a number for the ranking, and we'll start with Russia, France, USA, Great Britain and Korea. Russia will play in A1. France, in A3. USA, A2. Great Britain, in A5. And the last one from the pool A, Korea, will play in the box A4. Now we go to the second pool, pool B, with Italy, Hungary, Japan, Australia and Korea, and Croatia. Okay, Italy, in B2, Hungary, in B3. Japan, B4, Australia, B5, and Croatia in the last box, which is B1. And that concludes the draw for the Water Polo Man Tournament.
So thank you very much. Now we are going to Rugby 7, but we have, I heard, a small problem with our ambassador because the are they there? Anna Paula. Okay. As the ambassador did not arrive, we will have another ambassador to help, and it will be the director of the institutional area. She's not playing rugby. Anna Paula Voto, that is going to help us for the draw. So just to make a small summary about Rugby 7. Rugby 7 is an optional sport, and it will be only the second time that it is in the program of the Summer Universiade. The first and the only up to now Summer Universiade Rugby 7's competition was held in Kazan, but it was in 2013, with Russia as a winner, France as a second, and Great Britain as a third, completing the podium. But if you want to understand a little bit better what the competition will look like, we have to refer to the last World Championship that took place in Namibia. And there, France was the winner before Australia and Belgium. So let's go to the draw. Please, Eric.
Thank you. Just a small remark for this draw. We have only one country from Africa, one from Asia, and therefore, for the third and the fourth line, we could probably have to put those two lines together to make a balanced draw. But we start with France and Belgium for the first line. In pool B, B like Belgium. and France will play. In Pool A, Pool A France. Next draw, we have South Africa and Canada. The pool. In Pool A, Canada. And of course, in Pool B, we'll play South Africa. Good. Now we will, as I told you, have to probably group the third and the fourth line to make sure that we have a good continental distribution. And first we will place Argentina in the pool where we have no American team, means in the pool B. Then we will place at the end, the two European one, but we will draw them, but we will place Japan in the pool A. And now we will draw in the pool A and B, the two last European countries, Russia and Italy. Pool A will play Italy, and in Pool B, Russia. Good. Now we will be able to give them a number, and we will start with Pool A, France, Canada, Japan, and Italy. France will play in line two, A2. Canada A1, Japan A3, and Italy in A4. Now going to the Pool B, we take Belgium, South Africa, Argentina, and Russia. Belgium will play in B3. South Africa will play in B2, Argentina in B4, and Russia in the last box in B1. And I believe that our ambassadors are arrived.
Yeah, so thank you, Anna Paula. Thank you, Anna Paula. So we are going to ask, request the two ambassadors to come. Sorry, I don't know if it's FISU who is too fast or your taxi from Napoli who are too slow. In any case, I'm going to present the two of them. First, the lady, Giordana Duca, is Italian rugby 15 player. She plays as lock with Capitolina. She started her career in Frascati and raised national awareness very early. She moved to the red and blue, and after this experience, she came back to Frascati, where she was called for the Six Nations 2018. During this period, she played her first match with the national team against England and later played four matches. She scored her first international try against Scotland during test match. Welcome, Giordana. So, Diego Varani is an Italian rugby player, wing and former captain of the national team of Rugby Seven. He started playing with Rugby Lazio and then moved to Rugby Roma Olympic. He gained a lot of experience playing in L'Aquila and in Catania. He took part in the World Cup in France, playing with the 15 national team under 19, and later succeeded in playing with under 21 and under 25. His major victories are Rugby 7, are the ones in Hong Kong and the 7th week. During the last 4 years, he was captain of the team, coached by Andy Vilk, and he took part in the European League and to the qualifying rounds of the Olympics. Welcome, Diego. So what we told you about the women counts also for the men's competition. If you consider Kazan's results, Russian won in final against France and Great Britain, took the bronze. But during the last World Championship in Namibia in 2018, South Africa won the gold before Australia and France. Only one thing is sure, the competition in Napoli will be very open and no doubt that the show will be present on the Napolitanese field. Eric, it's your turn.
Thank you. We will draw now for the first line, South Africa and France. We draw the pool. In pool A, we'll play South Africa. And of course, in pool B, France. Now we go to the song online and we will draw Argentina and Italy. As we have four European teams, we'll have only a pool of two European teams. Then we will see what we will draw now, but second line, Argentina, Italy. We draw the pool. Pool A, Argentina. And of course, Italy will be in pool B. Well, as I just explained now, we cannot have more than two European teams in the pool B. Therefore, we will have to place Russia in the pool A. And the second team, Canada, will play in the pool B. Then we have one American team in each pool. Okay. Remain two countries, Japan and Romania. But as you can see, we have already in the pool B two European teams and only one in the Pool A. Therefore, we have to place Romania in the Pool A. And Japan will play the Pool B. Don't worry, we have still some work to do because we make the list of the teams afterwards. Thank you so much. Now we can give them a number. And we will start with South Africa, Argentina, Russia, and Romania. South Africa will play in the Pool A. A4. Argentina will play in the Pool A1. Russia will play in the Pool A3. And Romania, of course, in the last box available, in A2. Now we'll give a number to the Pool B with France, Italy, Canada, and Japan. France will play in Pool B1. Italy will play in B3. Canada in Pool B4, and Japan will take, of course, the last box available, which is B2. Thank you so much, and that concludes the draw for the Naples Universiade. I would like to again take the opportunity to thank all our technical delegates that have been present here and done a fantastic job. Thank you to all of you. Thank you, Jean-Paul Clemenceau. And thank you to all staff of FISU that have been here to help. We have Mark, Director of Summer Games, our Director General Polo, our Deputy Director Jing Zhao, we have Brian, and Arturo, two guys from the Summer Universiade Department, Lilia Barieva, who is following all the results now, and Tina, who has made the live coverage of the event, and of course my assistant Pandora that helped me for the last 4 days, and it's not easy. Good. Thank you to all of you, and I would like a special thanks to other people. First, our first Vice President and President of the Supervisory Commission, Léon Seder. And Léon, again, yesterday was an important day for you. You reached 66 years old now. Congratulations, it's a very important number. And if you want, we can go together on a Harley Davidson to cross the Americas with on the road 66. This is up to you. Then, thanks as well to Luciano Cabral, our Vice President, is here in the room, and he has always given great support to FISU. Thanks to Penina Kambenge from Uganda, a member of the Executive Committee, and Alim Malouf Neto, our President of the FASU America, the FISU America, who is also here, and thanks to all of you for your support. Then I wish you a very safe trip back home, and see you in 3 months in Naples. enjoy your stay again a few hours more, and thank you so much for your support. And again, thank you very much to the organic committee for the preparation of this room and excellent team sports draw. Now I invite the President of the Supervisory Commission and First Vice President of FISU to give a final speech together with the General Commissioner Gianluca Basile.